It changed my life.
It was a mighty work of God.
And God was telling us, hold on tight, you're in for a ride. Starts with what I can feel. It's all in your mind anyway. I can feel. I'm Nico, a man, inebriated, walked into the parking lot and began talking to us. As a team, we just boldly asked, can we pray for you? And he kind of stopped for a minute. He looked down at the ground. And when he looked back up, he said, well, what I really want is money. But okay. So we, as a team, laid hands on him and began to pray for him. And as we were praying for him, the man just broke and began to cry. He walked away, and we realized that ministry had begun.
My name's Amy. If I could describe my New Orleans trip in one word, it would be needed. For New Orleans, in that even though they've come so far in 2 years, there's still so much to be done and needed in my own life, because it was a constant reminder through that whole week that I need to continually look for ways to be Christ's hand and feet.
Hi, I'm Molly Sullivan. Believe it or not, this middle-aged Orange County mom of two college students was praying for, sharing the gospel, hugging, and speaking with, for a long time, this transsexual prostitute on the corner, the street corner, on the third night we were out. It was so awesome.
My name is Karen Nicoletti. I went to Wow Jam with Rock Harbor. We had only scheduled to stay till Wednesday, and on Monday, the leader of Wow Jam spoke and said that someone in the room would be called back for further evangelism. And all of a sudden, I just started bawling, and I looked around, and no one else was crying.
Hi, my name's Sean Scott. I'm on staff here at Rock Harbor, and we just got back from Mexico. God's changing our hearts and our desire and passion for Mexico and for the people from Mexico. I think he allowed us to see some things that allowed him to break down some barriers and some walls that we kind of didn't know existed, or at least I didn't know existed. And it's fun to just to have that freedom and see people for who God has made them to be.